Hello friends, this is Praveen Pawar. In this video, we'll discuss the paper 1 of UGCNET exam. This exam was held on 28th of August 2016. Here we'll discuss the question paper with their solutions from question number 1 to 30. For rest of the questions, please go to my next video. Its link is given in the description. This question paper you can download from UGCNET website and its link is also given in the description. So here we'll start. This is paper 1, test booklet series A. There was total 60 multiple choice questions, out of which we had to solve 50 questions. But there is a little bit change in exam pattern from this year onwards. Exam is going to be held in November 2017. And the change is that there will be total 50 multiple choice questions and all questions are compulsory. Means we have to solve all 50 questions. There is another change. Previously, there was a different cutoff for paper 1, 2 and paper 3. But from this year onwards, there will be cutoff based on total marks obtained in paper 1, 2 and paper 3. So, here we will start question number 1. In a PhD thesis, which one is the correct sequence for showing scheme of chapterization? So, first we write the introduction. Then we do literature review. In other words, we call it survey of related studies. After that, we give our system model, which we call design of study. Then data presentation. After that, we do analysis and interpretation. And next is formulation of generalization and conclusions, which is followed by our future research. And in the last, we write the references with appendix. So, third one is the correct option. Now, question number 2. Which of the following is not the critical feature of qualitative research? So, correct option is actual settings are the direct source of data. Data take the forms of words or pictures seeking to establish relationships among measured social facts. Researcher becomes immersed in the situation present or past related to the phenomena. So it's not the critical feature of qualitative research. Its correct option is third one, seeking to establish relationships among measured social facts. Question number 3, a detailed description of methodology of research is required in thesis, dissertation, symposium, workshop, seminar paper, articles, conference and seminar papers. The detailed description of methodology we write in a thesis or dissertation. Question number 4, research ethics has a direct connection more often with which stages of research? Defining and delimiting the scope of research, problem formulation and reporting of research findings, defining the population and deciding the sampling technique of research, deciding about statistical techniques and data analysis. So, about research ethics, correct option is second one, problem formulation and reporting of research findings. Now, here is passage for question number 5 to 10. First, jump to the question. What is not a consistent concern across the two organizational contexts? So, answer you can find here. For instance, company longevity does not represent a consistent concern across the two organizational contexts. So, company longevity. Fourth one is the correct option. What will be sufficient for an independent production company to be successful? So answer of this you can get here. This case, each new film which is expected to generate financial returns to the principals is sufficient for the company to be successful. So correct option is financial returns from each new film. Second one is the correct option. What does an advanced technology company expect from the learning experience of its participants? So its answer you can get here. In the advanced technology company, for example, each new product innovation provides an opportunity for participants on the project time to learn and acquire experience. And this same company intends to retain such participants, hence benefit from their increased experience on the next project. So here you can get the answer. First one is the correct answer, benefit for the next project. What is not the expectation of an independent production company in the case of its participants? So it's an answer you can get here, but the same company has little or no expectation of retaining such participants. So its correct option is retention for the next project. Why do film production houses value experience highly? So its answer you can get here, because experience is valued so highly and film production houses have such short time of horizons. So third one is the correct answer. Now question number 10. According to the author, what has been the focus of film business? So its answer you can get here, through the film business focuses heavily on exploitation over exploration. So its answer is third one, exploitation. Now question number 11. Internal and external factors that affect message reception by the students in the classroom are referred to as feedback, fragmentation, channelization and noise. So its correct option is fourth one, noise. A teacher in a classroom has immediate control over the self-selected methods of communication and the message, the audience, the noise and the reception, the feedback, the technology and the audience experience, the communication channel, other communicators and external factors. So its correct option is first one. A teacher in a classroom has immediate control over the self-selected methods of communication and the message. Question number 13. What do communicated words carry in a classroom situation? Inspiration, controversy and introspection, divergent criticism and irrationality, insipidity, irrationality and non-acceptance, power, structure and tradition. So fourth one is the correct answer. Now question number 14. As a good classroom communicator, you are supposed to know your audience emotions, silent cues, artful pauses and counter arguments. So its correct option is third one, artful pauses. Figure out the components of non-verbal communication in a classroom from the following: facial expression, cultural space and sitting arrangement, speed of utterance, feel good factor and acoustics, high sound, physical ambience and teacher learner distance, facial expression, kinesics and personal space. In this way, so fourth one is the correct option. Which of the following are the basic factors of effective listening? Opinionation, stare and glare and interruptions, aggressive questioning, continuous cues and fragment movement, me too is glancing sideways and offering advice, acknowledgement of thoughts, reflection and asking open-ended questions. So its correct option is fourth one, acknowledgement of thoughts, reflection and asking open-ended questions. This is the basic factor of effective listening. Now question number 17. In a particular code, hospitals is coded as HSOLSAPTI, the code of biologicals will be. So here easily we can observe, first H comes, then we write S, after that O, then L, then this S, after that this A, so and so on, you will get this letter. So similarly, first letter will be B, second letter will be S, third will be I, fourth L, O would be fifth, A would be 6, L would be 7, C would be 8, O would be 9, I would be 10th and G would be 11th and last. So our correct option is fourth one. Easily you can get this. Now question number 18. In the series 1, 5, 13, 25, 41, the next term is. So by observing the series, you see that there is not much jump in the subsequent numbers. So definitely there would be addition of any number. So we just have to find what number is added in the next term. So 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 plus 8 is 13. 13 plus 12 is 25. 25 plus 16 is 41. And after that 41 plus. So by observing these numbers, there is a table of 4. 4, 8, 12, 16, and next would be 20. So our answer would be 61. So 61, third one, is the correct answer. Now next question is question number 19. At present, a mother is 3 times older than her son. After 5 years, the sum of their ages will be 70 years. The age of the mother after 10 years will be. So this is very simple question. So assume present age of mother is M and son is S. So from the first statements, if we equate these two ages, so we'll have to multiply 3 in the age of son, then it would be equal to the age of mother. This is the equation we can get from this first statement. This is M is equal to 3 times of S. So here, after 5 years, the sum of their ages will be 70 years. So S plus 5 after 5 years and M plus 5, sum of these would be 70. So here is another equation. So the age of the mother after 10 years will be, we have to find the value of M here. We can put the value of S in terms of M from equation 1 into 2, or to make the calculation simple, just put M is equal to 3S in this equation. So it would be S plus 5 plus 3S plus 5 is equal to 70. Easily you can get the value of S, which is 4S is equal to 70 minus 10, that is 60, and S is equal to 60 divided by 4, which is 15. And easily you can get M is equal to 15 into 3, which is 45. So this is present age. The age of mother after 10 years, it would be 55. So correct option is 2. In the series, so by observing the series, easily you can get A, B, then C, D, then E, F, G, and next term would be H, I, J, then K. So here K you get in the fourth option only. So fourth is going to be correct here. I will match the last term also. D, E, F, then G, A, H, then I, J, then K, L. So third term would be L here. So easily you can get the middle term also. The Y difference of this is in reverse order. W, X, Y. V and R, there are difference of 3 letters. Then between R and M, there is difference of 4 letters. And between M and G, there is difference of 5 letters. So fourth one is the correct answer. Now question number 21. C and D are sisters, A and B are brothers. So here C and D are sisters, A and B are brothers, A and B are brothers. E is son of A. So here E is son of A and brother of D. So obviously brother of C is E, and A would be the daughter of C would be the daughter of A. And question was that B is related to C as, so there would be relation of uncle. So correct option is third one. Question number 22. Anil played 8 cricket matches. The mean of the runs was found to be 80. So if I will write equation for this, so assume the run in first match M1 plus run in second match and so on up to run in 8th match. So sum of this and divided by 8 will give us mean, which is 80. Next, after playing 4 more matches, the mean of the runs of all the matches was found to be 70. So similarly, M1 plus M2 up to M8 plus M9 up to 9, 10, 11, 12, 4 more matches. And the average of this divided by 12 is equal to 70. So the question was that the total runs made in the last 4 matches is, so we have to find the value of this summation. So for this we require the value of this term, and easily we can get from this equation, which is nothing but 80 into 8. So value of this is nothing but 80 into 8. So easily we can get our answer, which is nothing but 70 into 12 minus 80 into 8. By taking common 10, or you can take common 4 also. So 4 into 10 would be 40. And here would be 7 into 2 plus 7 into 3 minus 8 into 2. So easily you can get the answer 40 into, this is 21 minus 16, that is 5. 40 into 5 is 200. Third one is the correct answer. Now question number 23. If the propositions are connected in such a way that they cannot both be false, although they may both be true, then their relationship is called. So its correct option is second one, sub contrary. Which one among the following is not a characteristic of a deductive type of argument? So read the question clearly. Is not a characteristic of a deductive type of argument. The conclusion follows from the premises necessarily. The argument admits a degree of complexity. The argument provides us knowledge about matters of fact. The argument must be either valid or invalid. So its correct option would be third one, which is not a characteristic of a deductive type of argument. Question number 25. Select the code which states the condition of an invalid deductive argument. So asking the invalid deductive argument. All the premises are true but the conclusion is false. Some of the premises are true but the conclusion is false. All the premises are false and the conclusion is also false. All the premises are true and the conclusion is also true. So its correct option is first one. All the premises are true but the conclusion is false, which is invalid deductive argument. Now question number 26. Given below are two premises with 4 conclusions drawn from them, taking singly or together, which conclusions are validly drawn? Select the correct answer from the quotes given below. So easily we can solve this using Venn diagram. Here it is given all bats are mammals. So consider here is a set of bats and all bats are mammals. Birds are not bats. So here can be this. Birds are not bats. The birds, in this case, birds may be mammal also. So conclusions are given. Birds are not mammals. So here it can, birds can be mammals also. So this statement we will not say correct. Bats are not birds. So this is correct one. All mammals are bats. This is not correct. Some mammals are bats. This is also correct. So B and D are correct. Second one is the correct option. Now, question number 27. When a definition implies a proposal to use the definiendum to mean, what is meant by the definiens it is called? Lexical definition, stipulative definition, possessing definition, persuasive definition. So it's the correct option is stipulative definition. Second one is the correct answer. Question number 28. Select the code which is not correct. An analogical argument is strengthened by increasing the number of entities, increasing the number of similar respects, reducing the claim made earlier strong, making the conclusion stronger when premises remain unchanged. So we have to select the code which is not correct. So its correct option is fourth one, making the conclusion stronger when premises remain unchanged. Now consider the following two tables that show the percentage of students in each faculty at university and the number of foreign students in science faculty. These percentage have been rounded to the nearest whole number. There are total of 1049 students in the science faculty. Study these tables 1 and 2 and answer the questions that follow. So now, question number 1 is, approximately what percentage of students in the science faculty is that of foreign students? So total number of science students are given 1049. So we have to find total number of foreign students in science faculty. So summation of this would be 112. So 112 out of 1049, it will give the percentage of students in the science faculty that of foreign students, and comes approximate 11%. Next question is, approximately how many students belong to the engineering faculty? So as it is given, there's total number of science students are 1049 and here is 23%. So if total number of students are X, then 23% of X is 1049. It is asking how many students belong to the engineering faculty. So it is nothing but 9% of X. So value of X is here 1049 divided by 23%, and 9% of this X is nothing but the total number of engineering students. So on solving this, 1049 divided by 23 into 9, easily we can get the answer and it comes 410. Second one is the correct one. Now question number 31. In case there are 34 European medical students, then approximately what is their percentage in the medicine faculty? So here we know that this is the 1049 divided by 23%. This is the total number of students. Out of this, into 5% is the total medicine students, and is asking there are 34 European medical students. So out of these 34, it will give the percentage of medicine students in the medicine faculty. So it comes approximately 15%. So fourth one is the correct answer. So here we'll stop. For rest of the questions, please go to my next video. Its link is given in the description. Thank you for your attention. Your all suggestions are most welcome. Please like, share and comment and subscribe my channel Praveen 254888. Thank you very much. All the best.